All right, guys, here we go. In this video, we're going to take a look at everything Bitcoin and see that possibly we are now running with the metals, gold, silver, copper, and have decoupled actually from the stock market. As you remember, for many, many months, we were kind of locked at the hip with the US markets and NASDAQ. But now it looks like we may have decoupled and are breaking out and running away from those markets. So let's delve into the charts here and see what we come up with. First of all, it's just a basic daily chart of Bitcoin, all this sideways consolidation. And let me review this. I have before, the main three ways markets reverse is a V-shaped recovery, like we saw during COVID. And then we have the W-shaped reversal, which really is the best and the strongest. Where you make a low, high, higher low pivot there and then continue on. And then the last one is when you basically just drop down, trade sideways. And as you know, that was the FTX, you know, debacle and everything. But, you know, obviously that's pain, okay? And just like in life, the further away you get from that painful, you know, life situation, a lot of times, you know, the less you remember about it and then you can, you know, carry on. So bad analogy, but you kind of get the point there. So anyway, that's the three main ties. And as you see, let's go back to the 2020 just to show you what I'm talking about. There's that V-shaped recovery from the, you know, COVID slam down, so on and so forth. So anyway, here we are. Let me throw some things on there. And the thesis here is that we broke out of this little sideways consolidation zone right here. Basically, kind of a quasi inside bar. In other words, see that green bar? We were trading inside of it, wicked above it, wicked under it. Yeah, yeah. But close all these candles inside. Then we finally broke out around the 1st of January. Okay. So let's take a look at copper. Okay. Here's this gold arrow here. Of course, copper started its, you know, run after this consolidation in this wedge. Broke out here in November, you know, came back, retested, so on and so forth. But as you see, we kind of came up, came back in, and then broke out around the 1st of January. Let's look at gold. Same deal. We were in this consolidation zone since about the middle of December, consolidating, then broke out here the 1st of January. And then silver is a little different, though. We had this pullback, just a fantastic run in silver, but that's another story. And technically right now, let me give you this freebie. We're in an inside bar yet again. Yeah, we wicked over it, you know, didn't wick under it yet, but inside bar, everything basically is closing inside this candle bar. So we're going to sit on our hands, and this is the futures chart here, and wait for a breakout. Go long or a breakdown, go short. And then wherever it stops, we'll take those profits off the short and then roll them into physical silver, if that makes sense. Well, that's a video for another day, but that's what we do on the micro futures. And then let's take a quick look at the GLD. And again, you know, just like the gold futures, of course, we were hitting, you know, resistance up here across that red dashed line, broke out here the end of December, okay? And now let's go look at the U.S. stock market, starting with the Dow Jones, okay? And daily chart, same deal, consolidation, kind of a breakout, came back in. Now, see this chart here? You know, in this consolidation area, then, you know, just, I'm talking about just the recent end of December, 1st of January to where we are now, okay? Does that look like a Bitcoin chart, okay? Same time period. Okay, here we go. S&P 500, consolidation, a little bit of breakout, came back, retested. And where are we? Okay, there's Bitcoin. Does that look the same? NASDAQ. NASDAQ's a little bit better. It looks like it's, you know, tried to, you know, run up and out here a little bit stronger, even though it pulled back further than the Dow Jones S&P. And then here you are on the Bitcoin chart. Now, let me kind of change gears here, and this might blow you away. Let me go to the monthly chart. And what we're looking at now is the number of days. Let me pull this down so you can see it. And we're going to address this box up here first, okay? And this has to do with the number of days. And first of all, let me give a shout out and credit and ask y'all to go over and give him a link, a follow on Twitter, Nicholas Teak, over on Twitter, all right? Because he's the one, I saw this on a post he made. And he didn't put this part in 15x. I mean, if there's any criticism, I get the criticism, not him. Okay. So anyway, let me, I don't want to throw him under the bus. But all right, basically his theory or thesis, and he had it mapped out. I mean, it looked beautiful on his post. But Bitcoin bottoms approximately 470 days prior to the next halving. And on here, the halving, I put as a white arrow, so it would pop out on this black background here. So anyway, starts bottoming approximately 470 days prior to the next halving. And then we do a 15X once we pass the previous all-time high from the bottom to the next all-time high. And that's on the low side, really. And if you calculate it from the next halving, which is in March, I think 10th of 2024, the bottom started forming in November of last year, 2022, okay? Now that's his, thesis. Now mine, I went back after every consolidation previous to the halving. See the white arrow. Well, the consolidation, at the bottom previous to that, when it broke out, okay? The big green candle, okay? I'll get to that in a second. Anyway, the big green candle, the first one was, 153 days. And then if you added 80% to that, you come up in and around, the 274 days for the next one. So here, the breakout, see the blue arrow, the breakout, then the halving, that was 274 days. And then you half that, okay? And then 274 days plus 40% is in and around, I think it's about 7 to 10 days difference, okay? But we can deal with a week off, 7, 10 days. We can deal with that because, a lot of times we're in these consolidation zones, pullback zones and stuff for months, if not years. So, 5, 7 days, whatever, we're not going to quibble over that. But then if we take that 396 and half it again to 20% plus 20% gives it around 475 days, which still puts us in his Nicholas thesis of that 470, approximate day range. Okay, so we're still technically, according to these two different factors here, equations, that we're still looking at a possible bottom having been completed or started in November of last year, okay? And then let's go to something else. Let me take all this off, clean it up. And as you can see, right now we're a little less than 40% pop here for the month. Well, 42. Right now where it sits, right at this recording, we're 41. Never mind, okay. 41%, okay, 40% up, okay? We haven't had a 40% move, of candle like that since, we broke out, up this trend line there. But as you can see, when we've had these big, huge, bullish engulfing takeout clearing candles, clearing everything to the left, high odds, high probability starting back in 2011, as far as this chart will go back, 2012 right here, we've extended that move, okay? Now, what could kill this thesis? What could kill us having already bottomed out? This is the bull market. This is time to go. We're now decoupled from the stock market. We're coupled up, hooked up with the metals. And here we go, perfect scenario. Yeah, the digital currency group could, if you look them up, that's a whole video in and of itself about those guys. If you look them up, I compare them to like a huge wagon wheel. They're the hub all the spokes coming out is everything they're touching in crypto. And that's a lot, okay? Yeah, I'd hate to think that there was any, snags or something, under the covers there that we don't know about. That could really, drop us down into the teens, mid to low teens, if not, $12,000, $10,000. But even with the, let me go back to that daily chart. I can't find it. Oh, there it is. Okay. Even during the FTX, blowback here, really it was just a few days, and then there wasn't any follow through. I mean, we did pretty much a 180 reversal, came back in, retested that bottom, of course, which is, we put in a little bit lower lower low, then we came up. And then we put in that low, higher low, and then the rest is history. We haven't come back and taken that out yet. Okay. So even with that, I mean, crypto did amazingly well. And I think one of the things that helped us was that big slam down. Okay. That scared the hell out of people. And people that were kind of lackadaisical, oh, I'll just keep my coins. I'm in a quote unquote safe exchange, my brother-in-law works for him, but whatever. Man, everybody started pulling their stuff off. Okay. Now these exchanges, I would think they're actually, squirming to try to get the real coins back on their exchanges, because no telling how much, and I don't want to get into, conspiracy theories, but a lot of that, they were just selling air. Okay. And if they were really working with the coins only, a physical, so to speak, you know what I'm talking about, product entity, then I think all these prices would be a whole lot higher than what they are now. Well, that's, another subject for another time. So maybe that has helped there being less coins, floating out there on the exchanges. That may have helped, put some a supercharger or, to this move to the upside. But really, what I'm waiting for, and nothing happens until there's confirmation, is for the month of January here to close out. And if we close where we are now and are obviously higher, I think the party's on. Okay, just looking at previous breakouts and what have you. And then also, I've always had a theory that once we were up and over the 20, because you could almost trade Bitcoin over the 20 and start selling under the 20, and you would be making, catch these, the bull markets here. I'll get it out here in a minute. These bull markets, you would be able to, start generating some multi-generational family wealth here. Being able to do that, just buying and scaling it above the 20, and then scaling out, going short, whatever you want to do under the 20, and as simple as that. Rather than looking at these charts every day, 50,000 times a day, just use a weekly chart. We have a chart on our Patreon, shameless plug, that we use exclusively for scaling in, scaling out of these crypto markets. That's actually been very, very successful. And then also we have, three different forms of stop loss, because your first loss is always your smallest loss, to be able to scale out on those. But anyway, I appreciate you guys, watching, and have a great weekend. We will see you on the charts.